when I first came up here back in the revolution, back in 94, Newt Gingrich contract with America, all that, there was some real serious talk about really reforming it. And we're talking about that now, and we got this super committee, and are they going to go long, or, you know, what's going to happen? But there were two competing philosophies. You basically had the Dick Armey philosophy, which was the flat tax, and you can basically do your taxes on a postcard and send it in, although nowadays, you know, we don't do anything through the mail, so we'd probably email it in or something on something even smaller. But that was sort of one philosophy. And then you had Billy Tozen and Bill Archer, who was the chairman of the Ways and Means Committee at the time, who wanted to go for a consumption tax or a sales tax and get rid of the IRS altogether, get rid of income taxes altogether. And then we now have, you know, maybe a hybrid plan that one of the Republican presidential candidates has put forward, the infamous or wonderful or whatever you think about it, the 999 plan. And there are various versions. But I'd just like to see, and perhaps, Mr. Carroll, we could make this. I mean, you're with a very large and prestigious accounting firm, and if we went to one of those other things, it would probably make it less likely that folks like those folks over there and a lot of other folks might need accountants and attorneys and things to figure all this stuff out. Maybe not, but at least in theory. So I just like to throw it open for anybody who wants to take this on, and I've got about 3 minutes, so if you each want to take, you know, a little less than a minute and just go down the line, maybe we'll start with Mr. Capp down there.
I'm not entirely clear what you're looking for here, but
which is basically what you think. Would you prefer to have a flat tax? Would you prefer to have a national consumption or sales tax? Would you prefer a hybrid where we have both low right now, but could potentially be jacked up down the road somewhere? Or do you think we ought to keep the stupid mess we have right now?
I guess I tend to lean more towards a flatter tax. I know that there's a lot of other ones out there like sales tax and things like that. I think they have to be very weighed very carefully. And when it comes to us as small business people, is to seeing to it that it doesn't disrupt the job creation at the small business level. So it could be really any one of those, depending on exactly how it's approached and how it's actually executed.
Okay. Mr. Smith?
In all honesty, I don't care. What I care about is just consistency. And I don't think it's going to matter on a long-run basis for a business like ours in any way. Approach that is taken, I would like a 10-year or 20-year or a moratorium on change for a period of time. That's really all I care about.
Okay. Thank you. Mr. Murawski?
You know, any one of them, as Mr. Capp mentioned, needs consideration, and whatever you do needs to be, again, consistent, and it needs to be fair. My gut reaction, as I mentioned a little earlier, is I like the national sales tax or consumption tax. If you have more money, earn more money, you're going to spend more money, and you're going to pay a higher level of tax, but there's other, you know, drawbacks in that. People that are at minimum wage levels, you know, maybe you've got to come up with something that, so it needs some thought and some thinking, but it needs to be consistent, fair, and long-term.
Thank you. Mr. Carroll, if you want to clean
up. Yeah. A couple of thoughts on the choices, the flat tax, the sales tax, a potential hybrid. One thing I would say is I would agree with the sentiments that a tax system that's predictable, provides some certainty, and that's stable would be particularly helpful. We currently have a tax code where about 25% of the income tax will sunset at the end of 2012. So that creates a lot of uncertainty for people, such as those who are sitting at the table with me. That makes it difficult, I think, to make business decisions and other decisions. Another comment I would make is the flat tax and the sales tax are really very, very related. They're at least first cousins, if not second cousins. One of the characteristics that both of those taxes share is they don't fundamentally tax the return to savings and investment. They're types of either both the sales tax and the flat tax are both types of consumption taxes. And then I would go on to say that our current tax system is really a hybrid of some of these. We have features in our current tax code that make our tax code a bit more like a consumption tax through accelerated depreciation, through other expensing provisions, through 401ks, IRAs, defined benefit plans on the household side. All those provisions all reduce the tax on the return to savings and investment. And the idea behind a consumption tax, one of the reasons a lot of economists like consumption taxes, is that by not taxing or taxing less the return to savings investment, they're conducive to economic growth. But you do need to balance those systems from a distributional perspective. When you don't tax the return to savings and investment, where savings and investment is received primarily or disproportionately by higher income households, one needs to think about the distributional consequences of going in that direction. So those are a few observations I think are worth.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. I've been informed I have yet a fourth meeting out in the hallway, so I'll have to take off. Thank you very much. Yield back.